Hey guys, I finally managed to build a perpetual motion device or a free energy device based on the ancient Indian design by Bhaskara. On the internet, you will mostly see this model where bottles are attached to the circumference of a wheel filled with water, but this is not the actual Bhaskara's design. I've built the Bhaskara's wheel based on the original design by Bhaskara. Now, what this has is that it has hollow tubes for spokes, and inside these tubes, Bhaskara wants us to fill mercury. Now, I'm going to demonstrate how this perpetual motion device actually works. And I do have mercury, so stay tuned and watch till the end of the video and let me know what you think. Now, who is Bhaskara? Bhaskara, also known as Bhaskara the Learned, is an ancient Indian mathematician as well as an astronomer who lived about 900 years ago. He was the very first person to think of a perpetual motion machine, a wheel that would run forever. He also made several key discoveries, including the principles of differential calculus, 500 years before Isaac Newton. He realized that in this setup, the liquid would keep moving inside, leaving one side of the wheel perpetually heavier than the other, turning the wheel forever. But why do we need a wheel that runs forever? If we can invent anything that can run forever, then we could get free energy. Today, we are buying energy from external sources, but what if there's a machine which can run on its own? Then we can tap into it, make light bulbs glow, or run fans without paying for electricity. This is why devices like the Bhaskara's wheel are called free energy devices. Sometimes they're also known as overunity devices because they can operate at an efficiency of more than 100%. If we make a device like this, we can get an unlimited supply of electricity. Will Bhaskara's wheel accomplish the job? Today, the internet is full of these wheels where people claim that this is the Bhaskara's wheel. The design is quite simple. It has several bottles attached to the circumference of the wheel, and these bottles are partially filled with water. I just added color to it so you can see it better. I made sure that the bottles are filled with exactly the same amount of water. Now, if I rotate, some people claim that this wheel will run forever. Let us see if this works. I have an online stopwatch, and I'm going to spin this wheel and start the stopwatch. Let's see how long this will actually work. So you can see that this wheel actually was spinning only for about a minute. Now, of course, this wheel is poorly balanced and, you know, this is not the perfect model. But still, even if you made a perfectly balanced wheel, this wheel would have stopped anyway. Why? Because this is not the actual Bhaskara's wheel. As you can see, it stopped after just about a minute. So does this prove that perpetual motion machines do not exist? No, this is not the Bhaskara's wheel at all. This is not the Bhaskara's design at all. This is the Bhaskara's original design. I have designed Bhaskara's wheel as per Bhaskara's original design. It is a well-balanced wheel, and I've put ball bearings on it to reduce friction. The spokes are actually hollow tubes, which can be filled with mercury, and I will show you how to make it run forever. But first, these tubes have been left empty, and I'm going to give it a spin, and let's watch how long this rotates. So I'm starting the timer. And these tubes are empty, but I'm gonna give it a spin and let's see how long this rotates. Okay, so you can see that it stopped. As you can see, this device ran for about 2 minutes. To make it into a free energy device, Bhaskara advises to add mercury in equal proportions into these tubes. So I'm going to use a syringe to take mercury out of this container and put it into these tubes and put them all in place. Why is this important? Because when I rotate the wheel, mercury would flow from one side of the spoke to another, making the wheel increase its motion. Why did Bhaskara decide to use mercury instead of water? Because mercury is a very heavy liquid and has some magical properties and also does not stick to anything. Okay, now, so you can see I've filled up all the tubes and this is the last tube, but watch what happens as soon as I put in the last tube. This is going to be very interesting. But as you can see, as soon as I put in the mercury, the wheel starts to spin by itself. This is the perpetual motion machine, which will literally spin forever. Perpetual motion is actually confirmed by Newton's first law of motion. Newton says an object in motion will remain in motion unless there is an external force. Think of planet Earth and how long it has been continuously spinning without stopping. It has already been moving for more than 4.5 billion years. So how does this wheel spin forever? So this is a secret. I put my hand behind it as soon as I put the last tube and turned it like this. So this is how most of the perpetual machines on YouTube work. YouTube is full of videos which claim that they've created perpetual motion machines, and most of them, if not all of them, are fake. They realized that the best way to get free energy is by making fake videos and get AdSense money to pay their power bill. This is free energy if you think about it. So why does the Bhaskara's wheel not work? What really happens is that moving parts make one side of the wheel heavy and shifts the center of mass downwards below what's the center right now. So with the change in the center of mass, the wheel just acts like a normal wheel. It will slow down and then swing like a pendulum before it finally stops. About 500 years ago, Leonardo da Vinci took the Bhaskara's wheel and tried to create a perpetual motion machine. He added little balls inside the spokes instead of mercury. Of course, it's pretty easy to do this. All I have to do is add little metal balls inside the spokes. This is the Da Vinci's attempt at making a perpetual motion machine. And of course, this will also stop. It cannot run perpetually. So this is Da Vinci's attempt at making a perpetual motion machine. And of course, you can see that this will also stop. Of course, the Da Vinci's attempt at making the perpetual motion machine also failed. This will also stop because it cannot run perpetually. Why? Because as far as we know, all perpetual motion machines break the first and second laws of thermodynamics. Now, this is almost like trying to charge the power bank with itself. Now, think about it. Did I just make a perpetual motion machine? Is it a free energy device? Am I able to charge the power bank using the power from the power bank itself? Now, this is not to say we may never come up with an actual perpetual motion machine, because we do not understand much about the universe, and many of us have a closed mind which does not think of new possibilities. Think about it. Before Wright brothers, a lot of scientists were convinced that anything heavier than air would never be able to fly in air. This sounds remarkably scientific, but some people do break these quote-unquote universal laws, and then it becomes a matter of fact. For example, think about making a device powered by radioactive decay from an isotope with a really long half-life. If we make such a device, it will run for thousands of years. We already have something called the Oxford Electric Bell, which is still working after 175 years of continuous running. If you look carefully, you can see the little vibration. This is the bell ringing. Of course, scientists argue that these are not perpetual motion machines. But imagine spinning a wheel and it runs for 100 years without stopping. It would take scientists 100 years to verify if it is a perpetual motion machine or not. And I think by current standards, such a device would be a significant step forward in science. Plus, Nikola Tesla himself once said, quote, "No free energy device will ever be allowed to reach the market," end quote. This means that such devices are indeed possible. Some have claimed that Bhaskara actually made another device which did run forever. It is said that many of his writings and inventions were destroyed, and this technology is lost. Remember, many strange devices were invented in India, including the anti-gravity jar. So maybe ancient people did build free energy devices. So what do you think? Is it possible to build a perpetual motion machine, or is this just a pipe dream? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I am Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and also click on the bell button to get all the updates. Please give this video a thumbs up and do share it with your friends. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.